Okay, so where is Soumya? Did she join?
Yeah, I'm here. Yes.
So yeah, Soumya. So the moment we give in URL, okay, thumb rule of or, whenever we use or, it has to be there in the bracket. Thumb rule of in URL, there shouldn't be any space because there is no web URL which has a space. What mm-hmm. happens when we use in URL, CV, or resume, or about, or at the rate, or profile, it starts understanding up to here in URL CV, or this resume, about, and all could start appearing anywhere in the search results. So CV maker, resume examples, CV template, EN. Now if you see Wikipedia, resume. So though we have a huge content, that's the reason we are getting, but syntactically, this is not correct. It's just because we have a huge content available matching the search criteria, we are getting the results, but syntactically we would see some of the result where none of these words are in the URL, but they are in either in the title or either in the text of the search result. Let's see some results. Now if you see Google business profile, so here I have a profile which is a synonym of profile we gave right here. So the profile word is not there in the URL. So here, google.com business. So profile word is not there in the URL. It is basically there in the text. Now about linkedin.com. Okay, CV or is not there in the URL. It is somewhere in the about linkedin.com, maybe profile and all. YouTube. So if you see in this, there is no keyword which is existing in the URL. Okay. But any of one of the keywords might be existing once we open the URL. If you see this also, so this is the URL, profile is existing here, okay. Resume help profile, yeah, let's see this. About is there, we gave. Just because we have a huge result and these terms are going as a keyword search, but only in URL is going as a real operator search. But when we make it in URL without these spaces, then that's where it started searching for these keywords only in the URL. So that's the difference actually.
Okay, thank you, Shiv.
Now you got only 8 results. Anyways, you'll have to repeat, you'll get more results. But that's a huge difference. Okay, again, only 8 results. Additionally, we'll have to club later on, we'll see that. But that just to clear your confusion. Okay, so this is clear. Now slide share script, image search. These 3 we can quickly cover up. So,
Shiv, in 15th topic, right? You mentioned something like, does percentage operator exist?
Okay. Does percentage operator exist?
No, Shiv.
It doesn't exist. The answer is no. It's only
also
in our
when and where to use wildcard, I think we haven't yet covered, right?
We'll cover. We have
this. Out of curiosity, I have a question. So can we use wildcard while we are giving site command?
Can we use wildcard while we're using
site command?
Answer is both yes and no.
All right. We'll cover few cases it doesn't work.
For this is tomorrow's agenda. Wait a second. I don't think in this half an hour it will go. This is clear, right? So Google Image also, we'll just give the introduction to Google Image Search. To Google Image Search. Okay, so does the operator percentage exist? Any thought process? Someone want to say yes, and if yes, why?
Sorry, Siva, can you repeat the question?
Does the operator, like the way wildcard exist, does the operator percentage exist? Anyway, we'll cover that tomorrow. You can do your research till then. This is going for 30th. This too we'll cover tomorrow. If you would have understood in URL and site completely, then going sessions, I think you would be able to take it. Starting from slide share now. I'll just give some hints and you drive the discussion. Slideshare.net. So why we use slideshare.net? What is slideshare? Is basically a collection of documents, variety of documents people come and upload. So you remember in LinkedIn, people used to upload their resumes. Now also people upload in the LinkedIn, right?
Yes, in the featured column.
In right in the activity and all everything, right?
Yeah.
Let's see in case if we get some of the results like that.
We can try extension.pdf.
For what?
The operator will not work in LinkedIn.
That is Google operator. It's not LinkedIn operator. But in Google, maybe .pdf, we can use it, but not ext. They're all hiring only. Resume, Java, locale.
Yeah.
Updated resume, okay. Chana, we'll see this. Where is, yeah? I think they have removed it. Okay, so maybe this kind of a results. So when people upload these resumes or some of the content, where does that goes and sit?
SlideShare.
Now, if this resume is here, so earlier, LinkedIn and SlideShare were partners. So what are the content used to get uploaded in this activity or a feature thing? What it used to happen is all these resumes used to go and sit in a SlideShare. So let's say we just do Java, Bangalore, resume. Okay, so now we got some of the profiles. Let's say this one. And then a similar profiles. Okay, we get the resume, May 5, 2016, 2009 view. And all things, and then we have a download option. Here again. So earlier, when SlideShare and the LinkedIn were partnered together, this entire database, she would have updated her resume in her LinkedIn profile, and that resume came in here. Okay, then once the acquisition happened between Microsoft and the SlideShare, when Microsoft has acquired SlideShare, then they got separated, SlideShare and LinkedIn. So what happened in that case? What are the documents were there on a SlideShare? SlideShare took with them and then came script. Now people assumes, even I also assume now what are the documents we are uploading is basically going to the script.
But Shiv, now LinkedIn is acquired. Like now there is a, I think both Microsoft and LinkedIn are same, it seems, right? Like now LinkedIn was acquired.
Microsoft, yes, LinkedIn. Yeah, right.
So after the acquisition only, this SlideShare and LinkedIn got separated. Before the acquisition, SlideShare and LinkedIn were a partner. So whoever was uploading the resumes or any content here, it used to get uploaded to the LinkedIn, sorry, to the SlideShare. Even in SlideShare also, you used to see that there used to be a link. Your means I also used to see my LinkedIn link here. If I click on that LinkedIn link, it used to take me to my LinkedIn page. But now that functionality has gone. I don't see anything LinkedIn here now, but that functionality has gone. But whatever the data was there, that SlideShare took along with them. Okay, so now you tell me, if you want to identify such similar resume, how is the X-ray string you're going to build? So let's say we did a direct search in a SlideShare. We came here. Come on, yeah. Okay, we just did Java Bangalore resume. Okay, so we got results, 1 to 3,594 results. I would say additional filters, maybe in last 30 days. Okay, one only. So additional filters last 365 days. Java Bangalore resume. Okay. So what type of files? File types, I would say not presentation, some documents, because resume is a document. I don't want presentation or infographics. Okay, we started getting some results. Languages, I would just leave as it is. Not a great results. Let's say updated, uploaded that in time, because the acquisition happened, it's more than 365 days. So we say upload and time. Now we got some of the results. And then I just go and download. This is basically a direct search, which is pretty easy. Okay. Similarly, you'll be able to see a lot of similar results also, recommended and the similar results. What you do, just come here, Java Bangalore. resume and then upload it anytime. File types, file type, you just click on the drop down and say documents, you get the list of things. Java, Bangalore, CV. Okay, again, document type, and then we get all the CVs and all everything. And here also we have 1837 results. So that's still a decent enough with the contact details and everything. As soon as you go to this profiles, you'll be able to see the complete resume. You have an option to download. Immediately you can call them, reach them, anything. And again, whatever the text is there in the resume, the entire text is like this over here, as it is.
Shiv, is this the paid one, Shiv? Because it is showing this is the last option profile that you can view.
I think recently they mentioned. No, it's not a paid one. But the views are limited. Maybe in case if you're doing a direct searches, this document is a last document. You can read this month as a guest. If I log in, it will allow me to read more documents. So let's see. And you see, now I don't see any error.
Yeah, sure.
And also once I start downloading, I'll also start getting some of the relevant, if any relevant resume came in, then SlideShare will give me the notification also.
Shiv, you mean to say now people directly upload their profiles in SlideShare? Because
SlideShare collects the documents from variety of websites.
Okay. Not only from LinkedIn.
Exactly. So, SlideShare.net.
Usually, candidates will not upload their profiles, right, Shiv? It automatically parses this information from various websites.
They won't. But it keeps collecting the documents from the variety of websites. Okay.
These are all massive searches. Right?
Here, the recruiter guide to read. So once you see some of the content, then it will start suggesting. Followed you. Passive talent pipeline. Special offer. Technical writer. Stay up to date. So I actually deleted a lot of inbox. My inbox was crossing the free limit. So I deleted. So that's the reason I couldn't show it. But otherwise, once I view these things now, I'll also start getting a notification, because now SlideShare start assuming that she was interested in viewing this content, and SlideShare has my all the details. And I start receiving those notifications from the SlideShare if some similar resume comes to them. Even same goes with the script. So SlideShare has a search functionality here. We just search for that. Okay, now Java Bangalore. Just give like this. And then I also search for resume. Then we got it. File types, we just do documents. And then we open some of the other profile. Let's say we'll open this profile. So this is the individual profile of Arun. So this is direct search. Direct search, are we clear? Any confusion on direct search? Directly log in into the SlideShare. Sign up. If you're not signed up, sign up using your LinkedIn account or Google account or whatever. Once you do the sign up, you'll be able to access n number of documents. Even if you want to prepare some market intelligence report or anything like that, some presentations and all, you'll be able to search for those similar search terms here, and you'll be able to get those documents. All right.
So we'll not be able to use the Boolean operators here in the direct search, right?
No, SlideShare is not Boolean friendly.
All right. Okay.
Okay. So this is the profile. Now you know in title, in URL, site, how it works. Now you tell me how will site work for this? How will you be able to do indirect search for a SlideShare? Direct search, we have a normal functionality of searching with a limited keywords. Then we can say sort by documents and then last uploaded anytime. And that's it, we get the results. Now, finally, we came to this particular profile. Now you tell me how we can basically do an indirect X-ray search for this SlideShare.net.
Can we use in URL with inverted comma as keyword for indirect search?
So how do you want to use? Let's say, now this is the URL part. Identifying URL part. The reason I was stressing so much on the URL part. Now in this URL part, you tell me. Okay, let's say a couple of resumes we'll view. So this is a slideshare.net/Arun V6. And then /Arun V hyphen some numeric and so and so. Here slideshare.net and then /anuelz1/resume-a-some-alphanumeric. This is slideshare.net John Kaufman /resume-john-i-kaufman.com. So slideshare.net. Again here. So now you tell me how to use script. We'll go later.
Shiv, it's a slide. I would like to use slide operator and take this constant slideshare.net.
Okay, Prakash Selva Kumar, site slideshare.net, Java or Python, Bangalore, resume or CV. Excellent. Yeah, Sharma, you please tell. This is suggested by Prakash.
No, I didn't get what you're saying, Prakash.
Just a second.
So you want me to read out the string?
No, just a second. Notes for session 8. So Prakash has suggested this. Anyone else want to suggest something else?
Can do in URL.
Yeah, please comment in the, sure Neeraj, no problem. Please comment in the text box.
We can remove till www and use in URL.
Yeah, that's what Madhusudan. Can you please text in the text box? Everyone, please share your thought process. What is that you're going to use? Just share it in the text box. I got it from Prakash. Just take a look at how is the URL part looking like and what best results you can get it. Let me just take all this in one doc so that you can view it. You use in URL, you use site, whatever you want to use it, but Sharma slideshare.net Java Bangalore resume. Okay, so I got one more search from Sharma. from Anju. From Soumya. Soumya shared two, super awesome. From Parmeshwari.
I think you're copy pasting the same string, it seems.
Yeah, I'm copy pasting. Oh, okay. Sometimes it doesn't get copied.
And also, resume spelling is wrong.
I'll correct that. No. So this is from Soumya. One more from Soumya. Bangalore. One from Parmeshwari. In URL. Slideshare.net space Java Bangalore. Or Bangalore. From Prakash. Prakash, I've taken yours. Okay, one more Prakash suggested. In URL slideshare.net. In URL resume, Java Bangalore. In URL. .net. In URL resume Bangalore.
Should please add resume as well in second one. I have shared Java Bangalore resume.
I missed out writing the word resume.
No problem, that's fine. So this is from Rapia. Anju, site ke baad space hai. This is from Shravan. We might get disconnected in next 10 minutes. This is from Madhusudan. Rabia missed out writing in URL resume or CV. Okay. Resume or awesome, super awesome. Okay, so let's come back now. So these are all the strings that you have shared, and amazingly nobody missed site:slideshare.net or in url:slideshare.net, and that is something awesome, first thing. And then the second thing, we all mentioned Java Bangalore resume. Maybe spelling mistakes, that's ignore it. So this is workable, this is workable, this is workable, this is workable. Now, these were suggested InURL, SlideShare.net, InURL resume, Java Bangalore. That is furthermore optimized by Satish, InURL, SlideShare.net, InURL, because InURL, you know, you can use it multiple times. InURL resume, Java Bangalore. Site SlideShare.net, software engineer or software developer, algorithms, data structure, distributed, Bangalore, Hyderabad, resume or CV, 3.8, star, year or years or experience in URL, resume or CV. Awesome, Rabia. Then slide, SlideShare.net, in URL, CV or resume. In URL, SlideShare.net, in title, resume or CV, in title, Java or in text, Java or Python by Madhusudan. All strings are absolutely correct. It's just that
for how about the... mine, Chef? How about mine? I too have typed and sent it to you in the chat.
You have sent it. Where is it?
Your
spelling mistake is there. So here, if you
even see... mine is not there.
Okay, let me see. So this is in URL. So the spelling mistake is there. Site slide. So what do you want to use in URL colon after that? Ajaz.
Space shifts. No space. In URL hyphen no space.
No, but what do you want to use here?
A site.
No, no, I'm asking. Now you have given in URL. What word do you want to use? Okay.
Site.slideshare.net.
This you have already used. Slide site colon slideshare.net. In URL, do you want to use it?
Yeah, I want to use it.
So what word
you can give resume and CV.
Resume.
Or CV.
Or CV or and CV.
And CV.
Can you please rewrite the string and resend?
Yeah, sure. I'll do that.
Just rewrite and resend how you want to write. Who else? Parmeshwari, yours is there, no? Who else is not there? Soumya?
Even mine is not there. Anju.
You.
Shiv, after in title, I missed out on colon.
Okay, Anju has given one. Okay. This is Anju's. Anyone else missed? Anju, you made a slight mistake. It's not a mistake.
I sent two of them. I sent two of them. After this also, I sent one.
I told now there's a gap, there's a space.
Okay.
Not this way. So if we see this one. So after site, there is a space. Should there be any space? This space.
No, sir.
It shouldn't be. And then forward slash C sharp DELHI also, if we do this, you can use it additional as a keyword. No need to keep site slideshare.net, C sharp and Delhi. So what it will search? It will search for the URLs. It will search for the web links, which has a slideshare.net forward slash C sharp forward slash Delhi. And it's very unlikely that we might get results. Okay, we got it from SlideShare, but that SlideShare.net, C sharp, Delhi, digital, not the relevant one. Because of a huge content, we have it. So SlideShare.net, C. So this is something else. It's not even a resume. So yeah, Anju, the slighter mistake is this thing, We are just using still slideshare.net. /, you mention, don't mention, doesn't make much difference. Even this also, after that, whatever keywords you are using. So URL is for the individual profiles on the SlideShare, it's slideshare.net /. This text is there. We don't need that. Maybe additionally in URL resume, we can use it. So this text is still there. So that is a username. This is again a username. This is again a username. And when we want individual profiles, then this has to be left blank because username is open-ended pretty much. SlideShare.net immediately username. SlideShare.net immediately username. SlideShare.net immediately for after /, there's a username. So that's reason what we are doing is site SlideShare.net, whatever this part is there, we would remove. Even this part also I'll remove. Okay, resume is coming in the URL. We would go in URL. When we use in URL, we can use multiple times. In URL resume or CV, and then Java, and then bang. That's it. And we got the results like this. All are those resumes. Clear? Doubt, confusion? Yes.
No, this is better. Means I got it.
Sanjay, if you had been trying to look for C# developers from Delhi location instead giving it after site operator, we can give space and
include C#
Delhi a separate keyword, like the way, you know, Shiv has written Bangalore, right?
C# and Delhi. C# or .NET or what else? MVC. You can do these as well. So that you get this .NET technology and all everything. ASP instead of ASP, ASP. Or ASP.NET, and you get those. All right, are we good on SlideShare? See, you will be taught. That's the reason I was covering in URL and site so in depth. Now, similarly, script also, you just go, you search, understand the URL pattern of the individual profiles on script, how it is looking like. Tomorrow, you come back and tell these are the searches for the script. And similarly, after doing this, once you click on the images, you have an awesome magic. That's a Google image search. Just a short introduction to it. Tomorrow we'll cover more in depth.
It's really interesting today.
Shiv.
Yeah.
Before winding up, I have a question, Shiv.
Wait a second. Let me come back on that. Okay. So why Google image search?